The year was 1990, and I was on the phone with the executive producer of the movie Home Alone. He was trying to tell me about his stellar plan. He said that John Hughes knew me and that he was a fan. So I packed my Nissan Pulsar and drove it to the lot. I knew it was a Christmas film, but I didn't know the plot. I got in line regardless and quickly read the script. The Korean kid behind me had an irritating lisp. The queue kept getting shorter and my hands began to shake. I was starting to get anxious. I felt my stomach ache. The director waltzed out boldly and shouted to the crowd. Culkin walked behind him and took a labored bow. I quickly asked my agent about what had happened. He told me that that blonde-haired kid was friends with Michael Jackson, and he had called in early and ordered strict instruction. That Macaulay Culkin better star in this production. I could feel the anger burning, but instead of sulking, I knew it was my mission to kill Macaulay Culkin. I went back to the trailer park and started writing schemes. It was all coming together and working like a dream. I knew where he was staying, the Hilton Garden Inn. I made my way eastbound so I could purge him of his sin. I bought the evening paper and checked the classifieds. I found a gun for hire who said he was free that night. I got his fax and number and made a frantic call. I made a few arrangements so that he could wreck the halls. He acted very professional, and I knew he was a skilled marksman. Too bad he had a pretty bad case of early onset Parkinson's. He told me not to worry. It wasn't a big deal. Every time he aimed his gun, he always aimed to kill. He sat upon the rooftop and waited for my cue. He aligned his reticle and, without pause, I yelled shoot. He pulled upon the trigger, but the stupid bastard misfired. He hit an unarmed black man, which kicked off the LA riots. The cops were called quite promptly, so I quickly fled the scene. This plan had failed terribly. I would need another scheme. Undeterred, I called a friend who said that he could help me. If murder wasn't on the charts, I'd have to be more stealthy. We met up in an alleyway behind O'Reilly's bar. He said, "You must be careful, lad. This shit will cause some harm." I smiled and shook his hand and thanked him quite politely. You see, I'd brought some A-grade heroin and gift-wrapped it precisely. I'd used this stocking stuffer to bring some Christmas cheer. When I couldn't murder Kevin, I'd kill his whole career.